Thank you. than 16 or 17 are ready to join the novitiate. Let's consider the doubtful ones again. There's Ermengarde.
Reverend Mother, there's no doubt about Ermengarde. The religious life is no place for the pious.
You mean the pretentiously pious, Sister Berta? There's Christina. And there's Maria.
Oh, well, after last night, I don't think there can be any doubt in the Reverend Mother's mind about Maria.
I gave her permission to leave the Abbey for the day.
I told you, Sister Berta.
Ave?
Reverend Mother, I've brought Maria. She's waiting.
Sister Sophia, the mistress of the novices and the mistress of the postulants do not see eye to eye about Maria. What do you think of her?
Well, I love her very dearly. But she always seems to be in trouble, doesn't she?
Well, exactly as I say. She climbs the trains, breaks her knee, her dress is hard to tear. She walks us on her way to mass and whistles on a stair. And underneath the whipple, she has colors in her hair. I've even heard her singing really happy. But she's always late for chapel, her penitence is real. She's always late for everything except for every meal. I hate to have to say, Maria's not an answer to the Abbey. I'd like to say a word in her behalf.
Then say it, Sister Margareta.
Maria makes me laugh.
Reverend Mother, I couldn't be lost on that mountain. That's my mountain. I was brought up on it. It was that Martha brought me to you.
Oh?
When I was a little girl, I used to come down the mountain, climb up a tree, and look over into your garden. I'd see the sisters at work and sing all the way to Vespers. Many times I went back up that mountain singing all the way. Oh, and that brings up another transgression. I was singing yesterday, and I was singing without your permission.
Maria, it is only here in the Abbey that there is a rule about singing.
It's the harsh rule of them all for me. Sister Margaret is always reminding me, but too late, after I started singing.
And the other day when you were singing in the garden at the top of your voice.
Mother, it's that kind of song.
I came to the window, and when you saw me, you stopped.
Yes, that's been on my mind ever since it happened.
It's been on my mind, too.
I wish you had stopped.
I used to feel that when I was a little girl, and I can't quite remember. Please.
Raindrops on roses and dusks on kisses, bright copper petals and warm mittens, brown paper.
Reverend Mother, why do you ask? Maria?
and that we do expect it.
Mother, I know what you expect, and I'll do it, I promise.
Maria.
There is a family of seven children.
You like children?
You're very good with them. They need a governess until September.
Until September?
Captain Von Trapp expects you this afternoon. He's a fine man and a brave one. He was given the Maria Theresa Medal by the Emperor. It was for heroism in the Adriatic.
A captain in the Navy? No, he'll be very strict.
You're not being sent to his battleship, Maria. God bless you.
Why did the last governess leave?
Who knows? She just said, I've had enough of this. Und fucked up.
Why? Was Louisa playing tricks again? Putting toads in her bed?
She didn't complain of some, sir.
Well, there's another one coming today, and this one can't walk.
Oh?
She's coming from Nürnberg with orders to stay until September.
I hope we'll be home for a time, sir.
Just until tomorrow. That telephone call, is it for me?
No, sir, it was for France. Before you arrived, there was a call from Vienna, a French trader. I have the number in the pantry.
I know the number. I should be back in about a month with some guests.
Yes, sir. Do you know how many, sir?
Just two. Herr Detweiler.
Herr Detweiler.
And Frau Schreiber.
Who are the girls from?
It was the post office. Say the telegram. It will be delivered. At 7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. That gives me 5 hours to be nice.
Was that scatterbrained boy telegrams?
That was one thing people are saying that the Germans didn't get off. Jeff needs some of the other efficiency.
Don't let the captain say that. He never used whistle for us that he's fighting for his life.
He's being the captain of the ship.
I can't bear being whistled for. It's humiliating.
In the Imperial Navy, it wasn't always whistled for us.
But I wasn't in the Imperial Navy.
Too bad. You could have made a fortune.
This is your new governess, Fräulein Maria. As I stand your signal, you will step forward and repeat your name. You, Fräulein, listen and learn the signals. You can call when you want. That's not. Everyone in this house has to do with it. Here, I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
That is the executive house. Travel. The house. For all I know. Please be sure that the room is ready.
Yes, sir.
Now leave with the children. You are in charge.
Oh, pardon me, sir. I don't know how to address you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this whistle, Captain. I won't need it. Captain. Now that there's just us, would you tell me your names again and tell me how old you are? No, you would. I'm Liesl. I'm 16 years old and I don't think of others. Oh, I'm glad you told me. We'll just be friends then.
I'm Freezer. I'm 14 and I'm a boy.
A boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Rita.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Rita. She's Louisa. She's 13 years old. And you're smart. And I think you're just the ugliest one I ever saw.
Rita, you mustn't say anything like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
My dear, I wouldn't say so. I'm 11, almost.
That's a nice age to be, 11, almost. I'm Marta, and I'm 7 on Tuesday, and I like pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you are brown. Now I'm going to tell you something. I've never been in romance before. How do I start?
You mean you don't know anything about me, Rose?
No.
Well, the first thing you have to do. It's so father to mind his own business.
I
what's in here?
That's my guitar.
What did you bring this for?
For when we all sing together.
Don't sing.
Of course you sing, everybody sings. What song do you?
so, and so on, are only the tools we use to build a song. Once we know these notes, we can sing a million different tunes.
How?
Here, I'll show you. So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. Now you try it.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
Now let's try it all together.
So, do, la, fa, mi, do, re. So, do, la, ti, do, re, do.
But it doesn't mean anything.
So we put in words. One word for every note.
Wonderful.
Not really.
Oh, yes, you are. I mean,
2 days ago that you would be here, just this time of night, with a telegram for Franz.
Well, every year on this date, he gets a birthday telegram from his sister.
You see, you are wonderful.
Can I come again tomorrow night?
Oh, Rolf, you can't be sure you're going to have a telegram to deliver here tomorrow night.
Well, I could come here by mistake with a telegram from Colonel Schneider. He's here in Berlin. He's staying with the Gauleiter tonight. No one's supposed to know that he's here. Don't tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father's pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
And some people think we ought to be German. And they're getting pretty mad at us about pink sound and getting ready to. Let's hope your father doesn't get into any trouble.
Oh, don't worry about father. He was decorated for bravery.
I know. The only one to worry about is his daughter.
Me? Why?
How old are you?
16. What's wrong with that?
Thank you.
Dear God, I know now that you have sent me here on a mission. I must help these children to love their new mother and prepare them to win her love so that she will never want them to leave her. I pray that this will be a happy family in thy sight. God bless the captain. God bless Liesel and Friedrich, Louisa, Brigitte, Marta, and little Quero. And God bless for the Reverend Mother and Sister Margaret and everyone at Nonberg Abbey. Now, dear God, about Liesel. Help her to know that I am her friend and help her to tell me what she is up to.
Are you going to tell me?
Help me to be understanding so that I may guide her footsteps. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
I was out taking a walk and someone locked the doors earlier than usual. I didn't want to wake everybody up and I saw your window open. You're
not going to tell Father, are you? Liesel, did you climb this trellis to get up here?
That's how we always got into the stream to play tricks on the governess. Louisa can climb up with a toad in her hand.
Oh. Liesel, were you out taking a walk all by yourself? You know, if we wash that dress out tonight, nobody would notice it tomorrow. Then all this would be just between you and me. Here, you can put this on. Take that dress. Come back out here and sit on the bed, and we'll have a talk.
I told you today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I didn't.
Oh, it's you, Gretel. Are you afraid? You're not afraid of a thunderstorm, are you? Come up on the bed. Where are the others?
They're asleep. They're not scared.
Wait for me!
Oh, no. Look, come all of you up on the bed. Now all we have to do is wait for the boys.
We won't see them. Boys are brave.
You boys aren't afraid to, are you?
Oh, no. We just want to be sure you were.
Was this your idea, Friedrich?
Oh no, it was Kurt's.
Kurt, that's the one I left out. God bless Kurt!
Why does it do that?
Well, the lightning says something to the thunder, and the thunder answers it back.
I wish it wouldn't answer so loud.
Oh, well, maybe. If we all sing loud enough, we wouldn't hear the thunder.
High on hills, lonely goat herd, lay on lay on lay, deep pool. Loud as the voice of the lonely goat herd, lay on lay on lay. Folks in a town that was quite remote heard, lay on lay on lay, deep pool. Thus lay clear from the goat herd's goat herd, lay on lay on lay. Oh, holy, holy, oh, holy, holy, holy.
Did you tell Odette Lionel we're having a party out here?
Yes, sir. Odette Lionel, sir.
Frau Schrader, thank you.
No sign of the children, Franz?
Not yet, sir.
The Gale, those mountains. They're magnificent.
Yes, they're not like any other mountains. They're friendly. Look, that green stretch of woods over there. When the wind moves through it, it's like a restless sea.
And that sweet little village.
That's not a village. It's a town.
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hurt his feelings.
It's fun being with you. You're quite an experience for me.
You're quite an experience for me, too. Somewhere in you, there's a fascinating man. Occasionally, I catch a glimpse of him, and when I do, he's exciting.
Exciting? I've never been called that before.
I'm beginning to understand you better now that I see you here. You know, you're a little like those mountains, except that you keep moving. How can you be away from this place as much as you are?
Maybe I'm just searching for a reason to come back to stay.
Georg, I like it here very much.
Max can't still be on the telephone. I know he's desperate about getting singers for the Cultsburg Festival, but do like it here?
We'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have my rich estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation.
It is, and I'm president.
You president of a corporation?
After all, I've been in Jack's estates for years before he died.
I just can't see you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, Captain. Eric Ted Violet would like his coffee now.
While he's telephoning?
He just finished. I'm sorry it took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Colesburg Festival? The finest choral group in all of Austria. The greatest mixed quartet in all of Europe. And the best soprano in the whole world.
Max, it's something I'd love to hear.
So would I. All I've got now is a basso who isn't even Rotondo.
Well, Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
And why? Because my monologues never started looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Paris, Rome, Stockholm, London.
On Georg's telephone?
Well, how else could I afford it?
Why am I up here? I hoped it was because you liked her.
Of course I like you, Georg. Why shouldn't I like you?
You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
I like rich people.
I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them.
Speaking as a government official, I... Georg, is there a cathedral around here somewhere?
That's our abbey. Nuremberg Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
A beautiful one.
Good. Over the next few days, we'll have a visit all around these towns, listen to the Saint-Gobain's choirs quartet.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, yes. It was in a town just about the size of that one, Batman, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1930, they won the Colesburg Festival, became very famous toward all over the world.
Yes. Whatever came of them?
Well, by the time their voices changed, they were rich enough to live in America. Georg, who lives in that little dilapidated castle over there?
Rumpelstiltskin? Baron Elberfeld. The oldest family in the valley.
I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all your friends. Georg, why don't you give a little dinner for me while I'm here? Nothing very much, just something lavish.
Well, I wouldn't know who to invite. Today it's hard to tell who's a friend and who's an enemy.
This isn't a good time to make enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to welcome them.
It could have been an intentional sight because they haven't met yet.
I'll go try and find them.
Elsa, have you made up Gerrit's mind yet? Is he going to marry
you? Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
And you don't know what it is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's very simple. It's money.
Money?
Why, yes. You're rich, and he's rich. All the famous love affairs, lovers, half too strong. The carnage wins away upstairs, lovers, snark and snarl. The famous woman's fortune, which they seem to have no fear of. Lovers were very rich and very seldom here. Not a sign of them anywhere.
No, let's rush out to your show with me. Waiting nothing for my country. Never get care.
Sure, it doesn't happen to you.
Max, it's a good thing you haven't any character, because if you have, I'm convinced I'd hate
you. You couldn't hate me. I'm too lovable.
Violet, there's a call for you.
I'll take it.
My children have been running around the neighborhood wearing old curtains.
Oh, yes. They've become very popular. Everybody smiles at them.
I don't wonder.
They say, there go Captain Montrack, children.
My children have always been a credit to my name.
Oh, but Captain, they weren't. They were just unhappy little marching machines.
I don't care to hear from you about my children.
Well, you must hear from someone. You're not home long enough to know them.
I said I do not care to hear from you about
I know you don't, but you've got to. Take Liesl. Liesl is not a child anymore, and if you keep treating her as one, Captain, you're going to have a mutiny on your hands. And Friedrich. Friedrich is afraid to be himself. He's shy. He's aloof. Friedrich needs you. He needs your confidence.
Don't tell me about my son.
Brigitte could tell you about him. She could tell you a lot more if you got to know her, because she knows things, and she always tells the truth, especially when you do not want to hear it. Kermit is sensitive. He's easily hurt. And you brush him aside the way you do all of them. I haven't finished yet. Louisa, she wants to have a good time. You just gotta let her have a good time. Marta, I don't know about her yet, but someone has to find out about her. And little Gretel, she just wants to be loved. Oh, Captain, love Gretel, love them all, they need
you. Stop it. You will pack your things and return to the Abbey as soon as you can.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have said.
Now that you're gone, there'll finally be some. What's that?
He's singing.
Singing?
Yes.
Who is singing?
Your children.
My children? Singing?
I wanted them to sing for Frau Schroeder when they met her. Leon, you must hear.
Thank you.
right. I don't know my own
children. You'll wait so much, Joe. After I've gone.
No. I want you to stay.
If I can be of any help.
You have helped already. You brought music back into my home. I forgot.
To laugh like a brook when it trips and falls over stones in its way.
To sing through the night like a lark who is learning to pray.
German blood, huh?
I'm not in German. I am in Austria.
There's going to be an onslaught. I bomb you. Everyone knows it. That was the least.
see you in the Baroness here again.
Fascinator's charming, Galen.
I hope she isn't ill.
Oh, no, just a headache. I'm on my way to go see her now. We'll see you on the terrace.
Father, I don't think these people are having a very good time.
Half the people I invited aren't speaking to the other.
Well, Father, maybe they're having a good time not speaking to each other.
Oh, sir, Frau Schrader asked me to let you know she will be joining you in a few minutes.
Thank you. You might see whether or not she'd like this glass of bread.
Kurt, I haven't danced in the Antler since I was a little girl.
Oh, you know that? Show me.
No, I said I haven't danced since I was.
You said that, Jen.
Yes, the first the boy will meet.
Yes.
And then they go on a little stroll.
That's how it's done.
Your face is all red.
Oh, I guess I'm not very used to dancing.
Well, hello there.
Good evening, Frau Schrader.
I hope you're feeling better.
Yes, thank you.
Hello, Uncle Max. We're having a party.
Good. Tell your father it's sure to be a success.
I'm here now.
Max!
Elsa! Without a doubt, you're the most beautiful corporation president in the entire world.
Thank you, Max.
Max, it's good you're here. Oh, and as usual, just in time for dinner.
Mayor, did you think you could throw a gala without me?
Oh dear, now I have an odd man.
A little odd, but charming.
Lisa, would you go tell Frau Schmidt to set two more places? And I'd like to see Fräulein Maria.
Two places?
Yes, we need another woman.
Who?
Oh,
Lisa?
Oh no, she's much too young. I'll ask Maria.
You can't be serious.
But of course.
But she's a nursemaid.
I don't give it for that way.
I mean, I don't mind, but could you ask your friends to dine with Maria?
Well, why not?
Elsa, tell them why not.
Max, change in a hurry.
Yes, Max. We can use you tonight.
Freshmater, they're talking about you out there.
Come on, Georg. I've been talking to these people.
Brigitte, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Fräulein Maria.
Good evening, Herr Detweiler. It's nice to see you again.
Yes, you're going to.
I knew it all along. Frau Schmitter didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party. She was faking.
Brigitte, you shouldn't say things you don't know are true.
But I do know. I heard a set of
It's very important that you children like Frau Schrader.
I like her all right. Why is it important?
Well, I think she is going to be your new mother.
Oh, Fräulein. Father's never going to marry her. Why? He couldn't.
Why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you.
Now, Paquita, that's just the kind
you
of thing.
You know that.
No, Paquita.
Remember the other night when we were all sitting on the floor singing the Edelweiss song you chose? After we finished, you laughed at him for forgetting the words.
No, Paquita.
He didn't forget the words. He just stopped singing to look at you. And when he speaks to you, the way his voice sounds, and the way you looked at him just now when you were dancing, you're in love with him.
One more dance, Gretel, and then off to bed. Oh, well, I'm Maria. It's good you're here. You won't be dining with the children tonight. You'll be dining down here with us.
No, I can't.
It's all been arranged. You'll have to change. You'll have to hurry. Oh, and Maria, wear that dress you wore the other night when we were singing. It was lovely, soft, and white.
Shall I announce dinner, Captain?
Want to say goodnight?
Oh, no, not here.
Please, Gail. The way they did it for me last night was so sweet.
Not in front of strangers.
Please, Gail, for me.
Presto, chango!
Max, you're just in time! Children, now.
And the nursery and the surgery.
So they were extraordinary.
A Fräulein Maria took them to do it.
I've been looking all over Austria for nothing like this, and I find it here.
Oh, wait a minute, Max.
Seven singing children in one family.
Max, Georg didn't even want the children to sing in front of the guests tonight. I had to persuade him.
Ah, and you have influence. Elsa, you must speak to him.
Max!
Elsa, this is for Austria. And it wouldn't do me any harm either.
Sister Sophia, please take our new postulant to the robing room. God bless you, my daughter. Ave.
Maria has asked to see you. I know this took her a long time.
I waited until she was ready to talk to me.
It's strange. She's happy to be here, but she's unhappy too.
Why did they send her back to us? Do you know?
She doesn't speak. She hasn't spoken except in prayer.
I shall see her.
Maria.
This must have been a trying experience for you.
It was, Reverend Mother.
And has it taught you anything?
Taught me that I never want to leave these walls again.
Maria, why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back. I left. I left without telling them I was going, without even saying goodbye.
Sit down, Maria. Maria, why have you done this? Why did you leave?
I was frightened.
Frightened?
I was confused. I felt that way before, and I knew that here I would be safe, that here I would be away from it.
Maria, our abbey is not to be used as an escape. What is it that you can't face?
I can't face him again.
Thank you, Sister Margareta. Maria, are you in love with Captain Von Trapp?
I don't know. I don't know.
Tell me about
her. Brigitte said I was, that her father was in love with me. And then there we were both staring at each other, and I could hardly breathe. And then I knew I could not stay.
But you do like him, Maria.
Oh, yes.
Did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know that I did. That's what's been torturing me. I was there on God's errand. To have asked for the captain's love would have been wrong. But I do know this. I am ready at this very moment to take the vows of poverty, obedience, and chastity.
Maria, the love of a man and a woman is holy too. When you first came to the Abbey, you told me that you remembered your mother and father before they died. Do you remember? Were they happy?
Oh, yes. They were very happy.
And you were born of their happiness, of their love. What you must find out is, how does God want you to spend that love?
I pledge my life to God's service. I pledge my life to God.
Maria, just because you love this man, it doesn't mean that you love God any less. You must find out. You must go back.
No, Mother. Please don't ask me to do that. Please let me stay here.
These walls were not made to shut our problems. You have to face them. You have to find the life you were born to live.